again, and on this video I just want to say happy new year, happy 2023 for everybody. Many blessings in this new year, and as always I'm just here once again to basically give you my review, my experience on this journey of Full Sail. So this class is one of my basic class before I actually start my new degree on graphic design. So this class is art history. So if you're interested and you want to stay tuned with us on this video, just stay with me and let's get to it. So we're here once again, and this class was pretty intense because it's like a lot. Those super classes or courses that they try to push a lot in it, especially like on Full Sail, either when you like those online school and stuff like that, you got only 1 month to put all the material you think it should fit in there. So this class, it was called Art History, and let me tell you, it was so much information. Like, I don't want to say that it's like boring, because you learn from like this old art, and like every assignment was trying to like polish you or something to like really learn what art history is, learn like some basic like knowledge from everything. They give us provided like some little websites that you could check like different arts, like share, like from anybody. So a lot of like Frida Kahlo and stuff like that, or Bush, and it was just a lot, but it was pretty cool. Some of the assignments were a little intense, so you know, your girl didn't get like the best grades. But it was a good course, so let's just get to it. So on week one, we were under the visual language and prehistoric ancient art. Basically it wasn't too much this week. We were like have a few lessons learning like what creativity was, visual speaking. We have another lesson of the prehistoric, like ancient Greek and Roman. We have a lesson that it was like drawing or architect and stuff like that. And then we have two assignments. Questions. There was like 10 questions. The questions were not too bad. Some of the questions were not exactly what it was on the lesson. So once again, I had to like master it, like Googling and stuff. And your girl got a 77. But it's okay, it was okay. My second assignment was called Journey Entry, and basically we did this on all the weeks, like the 4 weeks we did a journey entry. It was just different topics each week. So basically on this assignment you had to pick like a type of art that you were like more interesting from the one of the websites the professor gave you, and I chose the Egyptian art because it's just like a very cool and intense type of art to learn from, especially because those type of art, it got a message, it got a lot to say from like years and years ago, so it was very cool. I chose two pictures from the website, and I did pretty good. I got a 79. sometimes because depends the professor or the assignment, they want you to like write these messages and use these words or use too much, and I'm not like that. I just get to the point. I can like move around words and make it look more fancy, but you don't have to basically follow the APA or IPA, whatever it's called. So you don't like you write it right, or you gotta cite, you use citation, you use it right. So they very picky with that. But basically, if you just like check the images, read it, look it up, and you have your own word, you're gonna do good on the assignment. You just gotta, you know, push your more effort on it. So that was basically what it was on week one. Plus, on each, not each course, but some of the courses, they, when you do like a post, you gotta reply. On this course, the professor didn't require to like reply to another student. You just gotta reply to your own work. And that's like an extra assignment under it, because she make you like either answer some questions or find another picture, different things, and you gotta reply to your own thing with that second assignment. So it's two posts on one assignment. So that's why I keep an eye with that part. Week two, we had the artistic traditions, medieval resonance, Islamic traditions, Africa, and America art. So it was a lot, because you, like I said before, when they trying to put too much on one topic or one course, it's just too overwhelmed. So it was like a lot. We had our live session. Most of the courses got live sessions. So we got our live sessions. We have a few lessons. She divided it from all the names, so we can like basically like focus one lesson at a time. So that helped a little, but it was still like, it was still too much. So yeah, for week two, let's just get started. We had medieval, Arab, and Islamic war, I think it was. We had art and craft, and useful like objects. We had the resonance and the Baroque art in Europe. We had painting and sculpture. We had Africa, Oceania, and America. Like I said, it's just too much information, but at the same time, it's kind of fun to see all these different arts from all these different times. So, you know, just if this is gonna be part in a lot of like degrees, especially on my degree, which is like graphic design, you gonna learn from art, because you eventually gonna use it on your own. I was basically just trying to like, you know, take all I could in my advantage so I could learn from it and have fun with it. So yeah, that's what I did. For this week, once again, we have more questions. It was still 10 questions. And this week I did a little better. I got an 80. So once again, like I said, when you read all these lessons, it got too many either videos, too many pictures, too many links to click on. So obviously, you gotta like balance with what the professor gave you plus what you wanna check on your own. Verify is the correct information so you can do good on your assignments, you can learn, and you don't get in trouble, or it's like too much that you fail the course. So just always keep that in mind. Second assignment was the journey entry once again, and this one was art and craft. Basically, on this assignment, the professor wanted to ask you, what was the difference from art and craft? Like what you believe is like the differences in it? So you gotta like basically pick an image of each one and explain like why you felt that was the differences that like separate them. So yeah, it was kind of fun to find it. You gotta really look all the images on that website and like really pick one that it goes from art and one that goes more on craft. Once again, you can always Google if you wanna see like actual other pictures of persons like actually like posting this type of art, so you can like have more definition like what art is which. So but yeah, I have fun doing this assignment and I got an 80. So yeah, basically it's just like I always say, go through the lessons, because especially with art history, it's a lot of information, like prehistoric information from now, and like learning from like other people, other artists, painters and stuff like that. So just keep an eye on that. On week three, we have the Asia Innovation and Change, Art of Asia. We have the 18th and 19th Europe era and early modern. This week was not too hard for me, but it was more information than the first 2 weeks. So the information was kind of accurate, so I did good on my assignments. But once again, when you get the question part, which is like the assignment with the questions, you gotta verify from the week before and the week you're in, because sometimes the professor divide the information or the questions in those the week before and the week that you're current in. So always go back to your old lessons, check the video, check the information. If you say links on your computer or anything, check it out. You say pictures, all those type of things, go through it so you can do good on the questions, because sometimes the questions go both ways. So by the questions, I got a 89, so I did good. Not perfect, but once again, like, basically each question costs like 5 to 10 points, so you gotta like make sure that whatever answer you get is the right one, because it's just gonna keep taking points out. And our second assignment and last assignment for this week was another journey entry, and this one was developing your eye. On this assignment, it was about the history of photography. So you had to take some pictures and take some of the elements that the professor was providing you, so you can know like what type of photo you were gonna take. I googled some of the names just to see what was the difference in between, so I could like go and take the pictures. So it was fun, because you know, it was around December, end of December, the holidays. So I used my Christmas tree, I used the some of my Christmas decorations and stuff like that, so it was pretty fun. Other people, they actually went outside, took pictures from like the view and stuff like that, depends on the element they show. So it was pretty cool to see other people's pictures, and how I did on my own, because I'm an inside person. So I just took advantage of what I got around me and did the pictures. So I will say that I did very good on it. Some of the concepts of terms that the professor gave us was like rule of thirds, golden ratio, unity, pattern, variety, saturated color, repetition, balance, and it was a lot more. But the ones that I chose was rule of third with this picture. Like I say, I use my Christmas decorations on it. The second picture I showed was saturated color, and I chose this, the candy cans. Very cool, very amazing to do. I have fun. And my third and last one was pattern, and I used this one over here. It was very cool to do it, because basically that will help you, this part type of assignment help you practice depending on your degree. Like with me, it helps me to master taking pictures better, especially for what degree I'm gonna be in now, which is graphic design. Those type of things is help you if you're on your cinematography, you are a filmmaker, you take videos, you blog, you all those type of things. Like when you take the right pictures and the right angles, the right depth and all the stuff, that helps. So it was really fun to do it, because you gotta like practice taking the pictures before you chose which one you like the most, because you gotta like master that type of like concept or term on the art part. So it was fun, and I got an 100 on this assignment, so yay. It was very fun and I did good, so that's great. Like I always say, keep up with the lessons, keep up with the videos, Google what you gotta Google, YouTube if you gotta YouTube, because YouTube got everything. And like people like me, we review our courses to help other students that are interested in Full Sail or they're already in Full Sail, and then trying to like know exactly what to expect on each course they're in. So that's what I'm doing it to, basically show you guys my journey and help others along the way. So this is what I do. Okay, so last and not least, we got week 4, and week 4 was more about modern and postmodern world. Basically on this week, it was very good information. This type of art, at least I was never like really looking into it, so learning from this type of arts from the modern and postmodern world. It was very cool. Like I said, it can be boring from some people, but it's very interesting from others, especially me, that I'm all new to this. So I liked it. Our first lesson was about the art in the modern world. We have global art, postmodern and modern. We have cinema and design. Our first assignment, once again, was questions. We had 10 questions. I did good. I got 100 on that. Our second assignment was called Reimagine a Masterpiece. And on this assignment, basically, was like you had to go to one of, I think the professor gave us like 3 different art websites. And you got to choose one image, one picture of this painter, whatever. And you got to recreate it. So you gotta basically like know, have an idea when you see the picture how you're gonna recreate it. Some people like edit it. Some people like actually made the picture with like items from what you got at your house and whatever like that. The image I chose was this one. It's like an orange, it got like an old type of painting way. And I chose it because it was kind of like, not easy, but it was kind of fun to try it, because with the phone or a camera, you can use different filters and change the depth and stuff like that. So I wanted to practice that type of themes. So I used some of the materials that I already have here. I used some cardboard. I used some of my kids' crayons to like make the lines on the papers and stuff like that. I put it on the kitchen wall or corner, and then I located, I used wrapping paper that you use to put on gift bags and stuff like that. I used it to basically mock what it was on the actual paint. So it was kind of fun to like do all this and try to like make it look like that. So I took a lot of pictures. I took like black and white. I changed the filters and depth and saturations on my phone. I got an iPhone 13. So I was just like mastering with my phone and trying to take the best angle, the best filter, and change it like that to make it look more realistic to the actual paint. And I kind of did good. I can show you the picture right here. I'm gonna leave the link of the stuff down below as well. So it was pretty cool, and I got an 100 on that, so yay to me. And then our last assignment was the journey entry once again, and this one was called the global present. On this assignment, you had to show some art or like find some pictures, and you had to one of the questions was like, if you consider the art and media like think movies, TV show, videos, museums, social media that surround us in our current world. And the question was like, what ideas or themes do artists concern themselves with today? So you basically gotta find pictures of like all these artists and what they are focusing on today's day. what they trying to do now with their art and paints and stuff like that. So it was pretty cool, because we all know that now, like, we all look for people's right, woman's body, our people's images, the identity, politics, racism, stuff like that. Artists put it on their work. So those type of things, you gotta choose like what you thought the artists today are working on. And I chose a few pictures of like working instead of being like technology, be on the phone, instead of reading books or learning more. Everything is like now with social media. We have like identity, feeling like, you know, you don't belong on your body, or you don't know who you are, stuff like that. So I chose a few images like that, because that's what I at least see the most when I see art, or when I see people like posting illustrations and stuff like that. So that's what I chose. A lot of people show other stuff. I got a 96 on this assignment, so I was pretty happy. And overall, I want to say that this course was very interesting. I got a 90 grade on this course overall, so it was pretty cool. I did good. I passed. That's the most important thing. It's not only that you pass, but it's only more that you learn from it. But yeah, it's just super cool. I'm just happy with this journey. I'm excited and nervous to see what this math course is gonna be, because I haven't taken math since I was in college in like 2015. So yeah, it's gonna be very cool, but I'm gonna keep you guys updated. So as soon as I finish my course, I'm obviously gonna bring my review of it. So stay tuned with me. And I just wanna say thank you for watching. Bye bye.